الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله، أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، أشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. We continue with Kitab al-Riqaq, the book of the heart softening narrations من صحيح الإمام محمد ابن إسماعيل البخاري رحمه الله. It is book number 81 and this is session number 17 and we are studying chapter 8 from the book البخاري رحمه الله. Named this chapter after a verse in Surah Fatir, verse number 5 and 6. Babu, he said, Babu قول الله تعالى يا أيها الناس إن وعد الله حق. O mankind, the promise of Allah is true. فلا تغرنكم الحياة الدنيا. Do not let the life of this world deceive you. ولا يغرنكم بالله الغرور. And do not let الغرور deceive you. إن الشيطان. Indeed Satan. So now Mujahid rahimahullah said al-gharur means shaitan. So it's a warning against two: al-dunya and shaitan. The promise of Allah is true. Inna wa'adallahi haq. Fala taghurrannakum al-hayatu al-dunya. Do not let the life of this world deceive you. وَلَا يَغُرَّنَّكُمْ بِاللَّهِ الْغَرُورِ. And do not let الْغَرُورِ, and I'm using the Arabic word, الْغَرُورِ deceives you. Look at the next verse. إِنَّ الشَّيْطَانَ لَكُمْ عَدُوٌ. Indeed, shaitan is an enemy for you. Is your enemy. This is why Mujahid, one of the students of Abdullah ibn Abbas, said the meaning of al-gharur in the verse is shaytan. إِنَّ الشَّيْطَانَ لَكُمْ عَدُوٌ فَاتَّخِذُوهُ عَدُوًا. Indeed, shaytan is your enemy. Treat shaytan like you treat an enemy. Take him for an enemy. Why? What is his agenda? إِنَّمَا يَدْعُو حِزْبَهُ لِيَكُونُوا مِنْ أَصْحَابِ السَّعِيرِ. Indeed, he is just inviting his hizb, his followers, to be dwellers in hell with him. Imam al-Bukhari also in this chapter, and I know it's quite early for you, but I want you to challenge your understanding now, and you tell me what is the relationship between the ayah, the verse, and the hadith Imam al-Bukhari is going to compile in this chapter. I'm going to quote the hadith to you and you tell me what this has to do with what you started with. So you want to hear the hadith? Imam al-Bukhari says, حدثنا سعد بن حفص حدثنا شيبان عن يحيى عن محمد ابن إبراهيم القرشي قال أخبرني معاذ ابن عبد الرحمن أن حمران ابن أبان. حمران is the freed slave of عثمان بن عفان رضي الله عنه. His name is Himran. someone who used to be a slave, and Sayyidina Uthman freed him بكرمه وجوده from slavery. So Himran said, أتيت عثمان بن عفان بطهور. I brought to عثمان طهور. طهور اللي هو الايه؟ What is طهور؟ The water. You can use طهور means what? Because what gives you طهور? The water. Like sometimes, what is the difference between wudu and wadu? Wudu is the actual wudu that you make. طب الوضوء? The water with which you make wudu. طهور وطهور. Likewise. أتيت عثمان بن عفان بطهور وهو جالس على المقاعد. And he was sitting down with a group of his companions. فتوضأ فأحسن الوضوء. He really made a perfect wudu. يعني he showed the people sitting how wudu is made. ثم قال, then he said, who said? Huh? I'm just making sure you're awake. Who said? Who are we talking about here? عثمان بن عفان. ثم قال, then he said, شوف هذه, رأيت النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم توضأ وهو في هذا المجلس. I saw the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم in the place where I am sitting making wudu like me exactly. So he's what? He's conveying the sunnah. Huh? He's conveying what he saw practically. عمليا. He's actually sitting what? In the same what? In the same spot. Rasul صلى الله عليه وسلم was sitting right here. And the Sahaba used to do this, by the way. Yani I'm going to get off here, but I'll come back. Huh? That's how I do it sometimes. Anas was one of the companions who lived a long life. Why, ya ikhwa? What is the wisdom? ببركة الدعاء النبيلة. Because of the barakah of the dua of the Prophet for him when he was a little boy. When the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam migrated from Mecca to Medina, his mother, أم سليم, امرأة هذه عاقلة. This woman, يعني, you can place all the Muslim women now in her skill regarding her what? عقل. She's a very wise woman. فشي immediately brought Anas, who was a little boy. Anas was a little boy. يا رسول الله ومسجر فالله أنس خويدمك. This is Anas, your servant. I want him to serve you. She's smart. Serve you. Huh? What does she want him to do? Learn. That you hear us on the pulpit all the time. عن أنس بن مالك رضي الله عنه. قال أنس بن مالك رضي الله عنه. أنس بن مالك. فالنبي صلى الله عليه وسلم immediately, اللهم بارك في عمره وولده وماله. يعني, أو كما قال صلى الله عليه وسلم, Oh Allah, bless his life, عمر, bless his wealth, bless his children. He lived, يعني, there is a debate how long, but certainly 99 to 110. So the debate is in this area. 99, 103, 107, 110. 103 is the strongest. وَكَانَ لَهُ مِنَ الْوَلَدِ He had over 100 grandchildren while he was alive. So, he taught the deen. He said, I served the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam 10 years. He spent 10 years with the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So one day, here is a hadith that he wants to narrate. You know, by all the sudden, he laughed, he smiled. Then he looked at the people around him, why don't you ask me why I smiled? They said, why did you smile? He said, the Prophet ﷺ was riding with us like this, and by all the sudden, he smiled. Then he asked us, why didn't you ask me, why did you smile? Then we asked him, why did you smile, Ya Rasulallah? So how they narrate the hadith? That's the relationship between what I'm saying and the rest of the hadith. Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said to the companions, I'm amazed. أعجب من مخاطبة العبد ربه يوم القيامة. I'm amazed the way the slave would speak to Allah in the day of resurrection. What will happen? He will say to Allah, haven't you promised me justice today, O Allah, on this day? He said, Bala. And then he will say, I don't want any witnesses against me but from me. I don't want an angel to witness against me. I don't want another created being to witness against me. I want only me to witness against me. Allah will say, we'll give you that. And then what will happen? Allah will seal his mouth. And then the hand will speak. The feet will speak. His body parts will speak. يَوْمَ نَخْتُمُ عَلَىٰ أَفْوَاهِهِمْ وَتُكَلِّمُنَا أَيْدِيهِمْ وَتَشْهَدُ أَرْجُلُهُمْ بِمَا كَانُوا يَعْمَلُونَ. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will allow him to speak then. And then he will say to his body parts, سُحْقًا لَكُنْ سُحْقًا لَكُمْ عَلَيْكُنَّ كُنْتُ أُجَادِلْ سُحْقًا لَكُنْ عَلَيْكُنَّ كُنْتُ أُجَادِلْ. May Allah curse you, I was trying to save you from hell. We go back to Uthman. Uthman is doing exactly like Anas. He found himself sitting in a place where the Prophet ﷺ was sitting. And he thought this is a good opportunity to narrate hadith al-Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, which he narrated on this position. He said, Uthman, رأيت النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم توضأ وهو في هذا المجلس فأحسن الوضوء. I saw the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم sitting in this place, and he made wudu and he perfected his wudu. ثم قال, then he said, من توضأ مثل هذا الوضوء ثم أتى المسجد فركع ركعتين ثم جلس غفر له ما تقدم من ذنبه. Look at this. Whoever makes wudu like this at home, this wudu, لو أي وضوء النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم, ها؟ وضوء النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. And then he walks to the masjid, and then he prays two rak'ahs, and then he sits. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will forgive all his previous sins. Now I'm telling you, I go back to the question, what is the relationship between what I started with and the hadith? Al-Bukhari. Al-Bukhari, by the way, if you really go into his sahih, that's how you need to treat. Why did he put the verse with this hadith? Why did he choose that hadith with this verse? Remember the verse? Do not let the life of this world deceive you, huh? And do not let the chief deceiver, who is the chief deceiver? Al-Gharur. Shaitan deceive you. There is one word that he said, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, at the end of the hadith, hadith al-wudu. وَقَالَ النَّبِيُّ لَا تَغْتَرُّ. And the Prophet said, what? Don't be deceived. What does he mean? Shaitan in so many ways come to us from the gate.
Oh, you're righteous, man. You're pious.
Look at you. You just got your sins forgiven. Because you need to know something. This is what hunted Shaitan. This is what got Shaitan in trouble. I hope all of you know that Shaitan, when he started, he was a good guy. You know that, right? This is why, by the way, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala what? Elevated him, brought him up to be in the company of the angels. This is why when we read the verse, وَإِذْ قُلْنَا لِلْمَلَائِكَةِ اسْجُدُوا لِآدَمَ. Remember when we commanded the angels to bow down to Adam? They did bow down, except who? Iblis. A lot of Muslims may assume that Iblis is an angel. If he was an angel, he would not have refused. Because angels what? Don't have what? Angels don't have the freedom of choice. Angels are... لا يعصون الله ما أمرهم ويفعلون ما يأمرون. So if he was an angel, like Christians do believe, Christians actually believe that he's a fallen angel. لا, if he was an angel, he would not have disobeyed Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The fact that he disobeyed Allah, that tells you that he's not an angel. He was not an angel. And in Surah Al-Kahf, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed his race, right? وَإِذْ قُلْنَا لِلْمَلَائِكَةِ اسْجُدُوا لِآدَمَ فَسَجَدُوا إِلَّا إِبْلِيسَ كَانَ مِنَ الْجِنِّ. He's from jinn. فَفَسَقَ عَنْ أَمْرِ رَبِّهِ. So, Iblis was righteous and pious to begin with. And this is why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala elevated him. Come and be seated with the angels. But now that piety and righteousness got to him, he started developing what? Kibriya. And he was the special boy, the special one, like they say. So when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knew that, because Allah knows what takes place where, so far he did not reveal that. It was not out, but this was happening in his chest, inside. Allah knew it, subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is the wisdom why Adam was created. One of the wisdoms. So Adam was created. And Iblis is like, who's this new creation? And he's going around him. And when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala breathed the soul in Adam, and then he commanded the angels to bow down, now jealousy and hate. Enmity, animosity. Imagine, subhanAllah, Adam came to this world and found an enemy. What did Adam do to Satan? What? Tell me what? Nothing. Like you come into this world, what did you do to Satan? What did you do to Shaitan? That as soon as you come down from the womb of the mother, what happened? ما من مولود قال صلى الله عليه وسلم. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم says, ما من مولود يولد إلا ويستهل صارخا. As soon as he comes out, he starts crying. Why? Because Shaitan stabs him. Except who? Maryam and Isa. Because of who? Because of what? Because of what? The supplication of Hannah or their mother. Hannah, when وإني, what did she say? وإني سميتها مريم. I called her, I named her مريم. وإني أعيدها بك وذريتها من الشيطان الرجيم. I seek refuge with you against Satan on Maryam and her ذري, their offspring. Do we have a similar dua in our Sharia? That can help us protect our children from Satan? حديث ابن عباس, when you go and have intimacy with your spouse, you should say what? بسم الله, اللهم جنبني الشيطان وجنب الشيطان ما رزقتني. Oh Allah, protect me from شيطان, and protect if I am to have offspring from that intimacy. Oh Allah, protect my offspring from shaitan. This is in a way you can protect what? Your children from shaitan. الشيطان, the point I'm trying to make here, لا تغتروا. Rasul صلى الله عليه وسلم is telling him, not that you go and pray two rak'ahs and make wudu, then all your sins are forgiven. Why? Because we hope. He can only hope that your sins are forgiven. خليك إيه؟ أرجو. أرجو الله أن هو إيه؟ يغفر الذنوب. Because sometimes Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commands us Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us to do certain things, and you see the reward is tremendous. Like subhanallah, Laylatul Qadr, as if you worship Allah how many years? But at the end of the day, you hope that you actually witness Laylatul Qadr, اللي هي عبودية الرجاء. طب quickly, inshallah, I think they're preparing the field for us, بإذن الله تعالى. Huh? We're here for the volleyball, right? Are we ready or what? Inshallah. So they are making the field ready, inshallah. And just tell me what time is shuruq, so this way we can play two rak'ahs. So we get the reward as well, you know, Hajj and Umrah, inshallah. And then we go out there, bi'idhnillahi ta'ala. What time is shuruq, inshallah? 6, around 6. So another 5-10 minutes, inshallah. Sounds good? Can you take 5 minutes? طيب. What is Satan's agenda? What is Satan's agenda? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells you, إنما يدعو حزبه ليكونوا من أصحاب السعير. Shaitan for sure is going to be a dweller of hell for eternity. So his ultimate agenda is to take as many of his own race and our race with him. الآية هو إن الشيطان لكم عدو. Allah is telling you, Shaitan is your enemy. يا بني آدم, لا في سورة ياسين, يا بني آدم, سورة الأعراف, لا يفتننكم الشيطان ألم أعهد إليكم ألا تعبدوا الشيطان. الآية وأن اعبدوني. Clear warning that Shaitan is your enemy. What is his ultimate agenda? He wants his own race and us to be with him in hell. But the question here, does he settle for less than that? Or he goes to you just like that and tell you, I want you to be with me in hell? No. He has steps. He doesn't come to you straight. He leads you gradually to this. Whether you found, if you look at the Quran, you find these verses, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا لَا تَتَّبِعُوا خُطُوَاتِ الشَّيْطَانِ. Oh, you believe, do not follow the footsteps of shaitan. So the scholars came up with, so the top of the line, he wants you to be a permanent dweller with him in hell. Now for you to get into this, what do you have to be guilty with? Shirk or kufr? Shirk or kufr? But what if he does not get you to do shirk or kufr? Which is la ilaha illallah. That you got la ilaha illallah. He comes in the area of Muhammad Rasulullah. What is Muhammad Rasulullah? Bid'ah. He convinces you not to follow. He gets you in this area. And some of the scholars, by the way, they said al-bid'ah ahabbu ila ash-shaytani min al-kabira. Innovation is more beloved to Satan than major sins. Why? Because the person normally who commits bid'ahs, innovations in the religion, he believes that this is what? This is the religion. But a person who commits a major sin, يعني if he sits in a dars ولا حاجة in a lecture, the sheikh, mashallah, فتح الله عليه, Allah would يعني get the sheikh to say words about tawbah, you know, the importance of tawbah. While he's sitting down, he can make tawbah. And he comes out of all the sins. All the work of shaitan is what? Gone astray. ولذلك ما رغي الشيطان أدحر ولا أحقر من يوم عرفة. الشيطان was never seen despicable, يعني feeling misery than on a day of عرفة. Why? Because so many people go to عرفة and they stand and they say what? يا رب اغفر لي يا رب, يا رب اغفر لي يا رب. All his work is what? God. If he doesn't get you in the area of Tawheed, that masha'Allah la ilaha illallah straight, huh? He gets you in the area of Bid'ah. Tab, what you run away from the Bid'ah? Masha'Allah, the brother is what? Listen, I'm gonna follow Rasulullah. Hubb al-Sunnah. Then he gets you in the area of the major sins. We're all weak. قال الله تعالى زين للناس حب الشهوات. It was beautified for mankind the love of whims and desires. وذكر النساء top of the line women, money, wealth, cars, horses, and so forth. زين للناس حب الشهوات من النساء والبنين. So he gets you in the major area, in the major sins area. But what if you run away from the major sins? You escape all of this. I'm not interested in money. I'm not interested in earning it unlawfully. I'm not interested in having women unlawfully. I'm going to marry inshallah. What if you run away this way? He gets you in the minor sins. الصغائر. الصغير. ولكن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم warned us against what? إياكم ومحقرات الذنوب. Be aware of belittling sins. Why? Because small sin here, small sin here, small sin here, small sin here. If you compile them like what? They can burn you. So those are what? Four. But what if he does not get you in the minor sins? You're still doing good in the minor sins. He makes you abuse the lawful. يأتيك في الأريا of the lawful. What is the lawful? Is it haram to eat? Huh? He makes you feel what? You spend the whole day eating. Sleep, is it haram to sleep? Huh? He gets you sleep all the day. Because when you're asleep, you're what? You're not working. When you eat, is it haram to speak? But he gets you mumbling all the time. Dum, 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 dum. So he gets you in the area of what? But what if you skip all of this? Look at this now. He works hard to mess up your ibad. Sahih? When we say Allahu Akbar, what happened here? Amazing. Amazing. This is amazing when you start praying. And subhanAllah, wallahi, I notice sometimes I would have a problem or something and I'm thinking of a solution. Wallahi, the solution comes in the salah. Somehow he gets to you in this area. All your problems can be solved in the salah. And after he says, Salamu alaykum wa rahmatullah, Salamu alaykum wa rahmatullah, what was it? He makes you forget it. Seriously, is amazing. But I tell you something, a lot of us may feel bad about this, but this is a good sign. ولذلك ابن عباس was asked, why Jews and Christians, Shaitan doesn't whisper to them while they are praying? He said, when you have an empty house, you think a thief is going to come and steal from it? البيت الخارب. What is he praying? Who's he praying to? ما هو he got him in what area? خلاص. You go ahead and sit and pray. لكن انت تصلي لمن? You're praying to who? You're praying to who? توحيد. The look. He tells you what? When you pray, you should place what in front of you? Sutra. Why? Because actually Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said that if somebody tries to cross from front of you, do what? قاتله. يعني don't kill him. قاتله. Meaning what? Stop him from crossing. Because he said what? هو? Because هو what? هو شيطان. يعني شيطان. يعني what we understand شيطان is what? Getting him to do this. To walk in front. Because he wanna mess up your salah any way possible. فعداوة. Animosity, enmity out of this world. وذاك الحسن البصري, they ask him, أينام إبليس? أينام إبليس? Does إبليس die? Does إبليس go to sleep? قال لو نام لاسترحنا. If he would sleep, then we can get a break. But he doesn't sleep. He's working. And يعني يا إخوة يعني نذكر بهذه إن شاء الله in closing. النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم, one of the most hated things by Iblis is unity. He hates it. That's why Rasul صلى الله عليه وسلم said what? إِنَّ الشَّيْطَانَ آيَسَ أَنْ يُعْبَدْ. Regarding you, my followers, Shaytan giving up the fact that he can be worshipped again. But he is contented, he is pleased with what? بِالتَّحْرِيشِ بَيْنَهُمْ. He is contented with what? Placing discord amongst you. Making you what? وَلَذَلِكْ. Look where he strikes. Just to show you how he wants to divide us, he strike where? In the foundation. Every single day at this time, Shaitan places his throne in water. He's the enemy of Allah. Like Allah has a throne in the seventh heaven. Huh? Shaitan what? Made up his own what? His own throne. Hadith Jabir ibn Abdullah, Sahih Imam Muslim. Every single day, Shaytan places his throne in water. And then the jinni, his followers from the jinn, they would come and he would say to them, "Man adalla al-yawma musliman albastuhu al-taj." Whoever does the best job, guys, today in deceiving Muslims, I will crown you with my own hands. That's how he speaks. I'm Karim Abu Zayd. Okay. Look at this. At night, his throne is back on water again. And these guys are lining up. Everybody. Wallahi, all of this from Hadith Jabir ibn Abdullah, Sahih Imam Muslim. I'm just يعني, using my imagination here. All these guys are lining up in front of him in order to receive that crown. One of them will say, "Satan, today I was able to deceive a Muslim until he killed another Muslim, backbit another Muslim, committed adultery. He stole the money of another Muslim. Good job. Until this one stands and says, "Satan, today I was able to separate a husband and wife." Subhanallah. He will say what? "Ni'ma ant. You come out. You're my man." Why? Because the Muslim family is the first brick in the Muslim community. And I'm telling you, the disunity that we have in our communities is a result of disunity at home. Because home is not united. And he strikes down there in that foundation. فنسأل الله سبحانه وتعالى أن يؤلف بين قلوبنا والعالمين. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to place affection amongst our hearts. والحب في الله يا إخوة, just loving one another for the sake of Allah. Letting go of our shortcomings, letting go of our mistakes, and just, you know, overlook the shortcomings of your brothers is one of the most beautiful things that you can do. جزاكم الله خيرا. سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك, أشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت, أستغفرك وأتوب إليك, والحمد لله رب العالمين.